You just got your brand new Steam Deck. You've already watched our Steam Deck 101, or maybe you didn't want to. But you might be asking, Robey, what do I do next? Well, you're in luck. Here are five quick things you can do to enhance your user experience with your Steam Deck. And we're going to talk about them right here, right now on Robeytech. Let's talk about five things you should do once you get your Steam Deck. Now, pregame, this is not one of the official five, but pregame, you wanna check for any system updates. Now, once you get to the home screen in your gaming mode, then what you're gonna do is you're gonna press the Steam button on the left and use the D-pad to navigate to settings. Use the D-pad again to go to system, and it's the second option down. Now, at the time of the video, the latest stable Steam OS is 3.3.1, but this may be, you might be watching this like way in the future, and it might be like 10.3.10. Probably not that, but who knows what they're gonna name it. Let's talk about the five things you can do to get yourself set up and off to the races. The first is increase your storage and buy a micro SD card. In fact, we have our micro SD card right here. It's a SanDisk Extreme. It's a 1 terabyte. Steam games are constantly increasing in size. And the other thing too is you will be surprised. I mean, on here I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. These might not be installed. Anyway, I have a lot of games. Number two, adjust some of the performance settings to increase your battery life. Now, with options such as like changing the frame rate limit, lesser powerful games may not need to have the frame rate limit set to off and the screen is 60 hertz. Now, we found it best to set the frame rate at 60 to match the hertz of the screen itself. You can actually go down to 30 as well. For instance, I have been running the game Steel Rising, which is a brand new game, just came out. You can change the performance settings, and we talked about that in Steam Deck 101, so you can actually see what the frame rate is. It runs at an average of 34. It's all actually set the limit to 30, which means I'm actually even using less power. Now for your brightness, this one is kind of a no-brainer to adjust. The screen does get very bright, so there really isn't a need to set it to 100. We found that keeping it just around 50, the screen is still very easy to see, and you're saving battery life in the process. We have a couple screenshots here where we have like our brightness set at 50 and we have 7 hours and 6 minutes of projected battery life. But when we set our brightness to 100 with the same 86% battery, we see that we have projected battery life dropping significantly to 5 hours and 27 minutes. That's just an hour and 39 minutes gain just by setting the brightness down to 50%. And again, you can choose something in between there. This may be a personal choice, but do yourself a favor and adjust it. Plus, you know what? It's actually gonna help your eyes, you know, saving you from the blue light. Now, the last one for performance setting is setting a thermal power limit to limit the processor power for a total of less power. Now, this is an ongoing thing to adjust because you just don't know how much processing power is for each game. So for instance, try setting the thermal power limit to like 8 or 10, and then try running some of the games you have in your library. If they don't run smoothly or the thing shuts down, then you know that your limit is too low. Now, if they run smoothly with no issues whatsoever, you can do one of two things. You can leave it there on the lower to get even more and find kind of that sweet spot. And then you can increase your battery life potentially by an hour or more on the deck. The Steam Deck usually runs around 1000 megahertz clock speed on the GPU by default, but you can turn this down and adjust to make the clock speed as high as 1600 megahertz for like those more demanding games like God of War or Cyberpunk. And the more power, obviously, that the GPU is gonna use, the more battery life you save or lose depending on which way you go. So far, we've been able to leave it off and run most games with little to no issue. Now, those are some of just the few options you can do to increase your battery life on the deck and just keep playing. So that's the second one. And there was like 15 in there. So like you're like a bonus. Okay, so let's talk about the third one. Go through your Steam Deck library and see which ones Valve calls great on deck. Each game will have a green check mark in the lower right hand, certifying it to work on the deck with no issues. Other games, you have things like the white question mark or a yellow circle with an exclamation point in it, or even the dreaded circle with a line through it. It means that the game is not yet playable on Steam Deck natively. So for instance, on Steel Rising, when I load that game, what you actually will see in the UI is like a test pattern, but when you actually get into the game runs absolutely fine with no issues whatsoever. It just means that it may take some extra work or some extra effort to get you to be able to play the game and run it. Okay, so the fourth item is get familiar with the Steam Deck shortcuts. If you press and hold the Steam button like I'm doing here, you're gonna get a list of shortcuts on the screen to give you an idea of what everything on the deck can do. The screenshot shortcut, which is the Steam button and right bumper, is Tom's favorite as he takes a lot of screenshots for the videos and stuff that you see here for the deck along with videos to come. Now finally, the fifth, or like the 50th, depending on how you're counting, but we're gonna call it five, is remap the four back buttons on the back side of the deck. In any game, after you launch it, press the Steam button and use the D-pad to scroll over to the controller settings. You can create your own mapping for it, or you can even look what the community has created and uploaded for some of theirs. And you can check those out on like Reddit, the Steam forums, etc., especially for the ones that are great on deck. Now, once you've created your own mapping for it under like Edit Layout, and you find something that suits or works for you, click the gear icon next to Edit Layout. From here, you can actually export the layout, show the details, or even share your layout with other people in the Steam community, as there may be other people out there that find your layout just what they needed to finally get their first victory in Apex Legends, or potentially if you're playing a brand new game, like for instance, the game that we've been showing a little bit earlier. And there you have it, guys. Five things to do, or 20 things to do once you get your Steam Deck. Now, what did you think of the video? Did these five things help you? Is there something else there that you would love to see on the Steam Deck turn into a video? We have our guy, our editor Tom, who is doing all the writing and producing content every week for the Steam Deck for these video releases. So if there's something you'd love to see, then please leave a comment down below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and you know what, just gingerly, like lightly press that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a new video right here on Robeytech. Did you guys know we also have a live channel where we basically do just live builds of systems like this? Not this one, that's actually a pre-built, but there are somewhere in here. We do live builds of systems. So make sure you head on down, look in the description below for Robeytech Live. Also, we have an amazing community. You should go check them out over at discord.gg/Robeytech, where we love to talk about things like the Steam Deck, PC building, Mac gaming, you name it. So many different communities. Tens of thousands of people who are on that server. So if you're looking for a great community to just hang out, head over to discord.gg/Robeytech. And while you're at it, feel free to follow me on all the other socials. We got TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, you name it. You can check out awesome videos like the one that we did with Liquid House, which you can check out right here, where we built like that portable gaming stuff. Or you can check out like just beautiful PC builds like the ones that we have over on Instagram. So you can check that out too. Or you know what, honestly, you can just enjoy this video and look forward to seeing you on the next one.